What's up, YouTube? My name is J-Max. As you can see, it's just me, and I'm back to react to another one of your recommendations. What do we got on deck today? Minchin. Let's go! Yo. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel if you've been here before. If you're new, it's nice to meet you. My name is J-Max. I'm just a guy on the internet who really enjoys music and will listen to basically whatever you tell me to. Today, I'm jumping into yet another Minchin skit, song. I'm not really sure what to call these, but Minchin is an incredible, incredible musical comedian, and I reacted to his Prejudice song that he had. And I will say the comments that you guys have left and the breakdowns that you have provided me have let me know that I really need to pay attention to what this guy is saying. I mean, clearly there are double, potentially triple entendres that this guy has that have gone directly over my head. And also the fact that he's Australian. I'm not Australian. I know there's some Australian slang that I'm just... it's not a part of my vernacular. So, I mean, the only Australian terminology I know is from videos I watch of, like, Aussie Man reviews or something like that. So you guys, let me know. I'm really excited to get into this one. This one is Lullaby by Minchin. This is just one of many that you guys have told me to check out. And I do plan on checking out all of these Minchin songs because these are a lot of fun to try to break down. I love songs like this that really get you to thinking about what it is that he's talking about, what it is that he's really saying in these songs, in these messages. So, you know, without further ado, man, let's jump into this lullaby. Let's jump into this lullaby real quick. Let's see what he's got going on here.
Sleep, little baby.
Now, first of all, this is like... what was this, 11 years ago this was posted? Like, the highest quality was 240p. Look at, I can't see no definition on any of these people in the back. Anyways, that's not important. I got sidetracked. Let's start this over.
Sleep, little baby, sleep now, my love. The Milky Way's shining high up above. When you grow up, you will learn all that stuff. But for now, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Sleep, little baby. Try not to squawk. Tomorrow and tomorrow, you'll learn how to walk. To love and laugh. To make toast and talk. But for now, Betty buys. Your blankets hand-knitted with pure Angora wool. Your nappy is dry and your tummy is full of enough antihistamine to chill out a bull.
Yeah. Hold on, wait a minute. What are we talking about here? Antihistamines? I'm sorry, huh? Okay, where is this going? It seems like every time I'd react to Minchin, I'm like, where is this going? And I really don't know. Shit.
To chill out a bull, yet still all this gringing. What more could you want for? I just cannot guess. You constantly complain to me. You should feel blessed. There are children in Africa,
oh no,
starving to death.
Oh no.
And you don't hear them whinging.
Oh god. Oh no.
What more can I do to put a stop to this mind-numbing noise you are making?
I'm not gonna lie, as a parent of two, this is hitting me a little differently. Because when they're not sleeping and they're just constantly whining or crying, you're like, what do you want, child? Oh my goodness, this is hitting me a little bit differently than the last one.
Stop to this mind-numbing noise you are making. Where is the line between patting and hitting? When is rocking rocking, and when is it shaking? I don't know what else I can do to try and hush you. My heart says I love you, but my brain's thinking, fuck you. Holding a child.
No, why have I been there before? No. Damn. I feel called out. I feel attacked. I'm not going to lie. Fuck.
Oh, what else I can do
shit.
To try and hush you. My heart says I love you, but my brain's thinking, fuck you. I'm hoping a child trafficker will abduct you.
No.
At least then I'll get a few hours in bed. I've shushed and I've cooed, and I've even tried to sing oh bloody oh blada in the exact voice of Ringo. Now all I have left is to hope that a dingo will sleep
in and rip off your... Not the dingo ate my baby. No, is this where this originated from? I really don't know where that like phrase or like meme, I don't really know what it is. Is it like a real thing? Oh no.
Is to hope that a dingo will sneak in and rip off your fat bitching head.
Oh no. Tim be shredding that piano, though.
Oh, hush, little baby, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird in the hope you get avian flu. The nice folk in A&E will take care of you.
Dude. He is flying on those keys right now. Golly, jeez.
That's it. Close your eyes. Not a sound. I can barely see your tiny belly moving up and down. One thing they don't mention in the parenting book, your love for them grows the closer to dead they look.
I feel so bad laughing at this. Oh, this is like my deepest, darkest thoughts as a parent, especially when it's like 3 a.m, the baby just won't fall asleep, and you just have that visceral, you just want to, but you can't, you want to, but you can't, and you just got to hold it and hold that tension in your shoulders and not let it get to your fingertips. Oh, I feel this. Oh my gosh. Tim.
In the parenting book,
oh.
Your love for them grows the closer to dead they look.
Wow. Wow. That was Tim Minchin's Lullaby. This dude is absolutely hilarious. Like, that was great. That was great. Honestly, like I said, as a parent of two, I have an 8-year-old and my youngest is about to be 1 in like a week, breaking the fourth wall. But I feel that, man. It's those late night moments that they don't tell you about. I mean, all parents will say they love their babies, and I love my babies. I love my babies to death. I would do anything and everything for them. They are my world. But I can't help. I'm a human. If I don't get my sleep, if I am interrupted from eating or something of that nature, I can't help it. It's like in the back of my head. It's like this little, you little shit. Would you just like sleep? for 12 hours? That'd be great. I would love that. That was hilarious, man. I really enjoyed that one. I'm definitely going to be checking out so much more Tim Minchin. I have a whole list of going that you guys have provided me so far. And keep them coming, please, because this dude is great. And clearly, I have a lot to catch up on. Like, these videos were posted years ago. So, I don't know. Is he still making stuff now? Like, is he still active? Or am I going to eventually hit a point where I've seen all Tim Minchin and I kind of want to see all Tim Minchin? Like, I'm super invested in this guy. And I know this doesn't seem like it was one of his deeper ones. In terms of the last one, Prejudice had so many different meanings and ways that you could break down the song and interpret what he was saying. This one seemed a little bit more straightforward. But again, I would love to talk to you guys about it and see what you really think about this Lullaby video. And I don't know if there's anything that I missed. I don't think so. I think I caught most of the stuff. Like I said, it felt pretty straightforward. But then again, in the moment, so did Prejudice for me. So, you know, let's have a discussion, man. I love having a discourse with you guys down in the comments. It's super fun to see kind of how you guys break down these things and what you think his different songs mean and stuff like that. So let me know of some other stuff that I could check out from Tim Minchin. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any other Tim Minchin reactions that I'm going to do. And I plan on doing a bunch of them. So don't miss out on a single one, man. I think they're going to be a lot of fun. And, you know, with that, I'll see you guys in the next one. You have a blessed day. Peace. Yo, 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 yo.